guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 1 and 2 of Blue Lock. Yeah, I'm finally doing this. Okay, so let me tell you a little history of, or the situation between me and this show. So originally, when this was airing, I wanted to say maybe about 2 to 4 weeks of this airing. I actually, because people were talking about it and they were like, oh, this is good with, you know, minor details, but it's still good. I had said this one random day. I was home by myself. I didn't have work. So I was like, okay, I have free time. I'll watch the first 2 episodes. So I watched the first 2 episodes on my own and never really continued. I think I got so busy between work and work number 2. Hi, how you doing? That I did not really have time to sit down and really watch this. And I was like, you know what? Well, you know, maybe one day I might just watch it from the beginning, from episode 1 all the way to the end. Or, knowing me and how I always do with everything else, I end up making it a reaction series so that I could just go ahead and watch everything all in one go and such, bi-weekly and such. And due to that, plus some really nice, throughout the months of this airing, really nice TikToks that got me even more addicted to this show, even though I hadn't sat down and watched everything else, I was just like, fuck it, we're doing it. And it got worse, like, almost every freaking week or month. And there's 2 guys. 2. As of right now. That I am smitten with. My first one. He's on the freaking, he's my thumbnail. He's the one in red on the left. My second, is the redhead. Because I was like, oh, he's so cute and such. So, my number 1, red, emo boy, yes! Like, I was just like, oh my god. But it's worse on who he's voiced by. But when we get there, like, you know. But, yeah, these 2, since I have not seen these first 2 episodes in a hot minute, it'll be, like, a refresher for me. And then, you know, once we get to 3 to the end of the series, that'll be all new for me. But other than that, let's go ahead and get started with episode 1. In 3, 2, 1, go. Damn it. Hold on. I'm gonna stop this right here, so give me a second. Okay, sorry about that. I don't know what the freak happened. It just wanted to be stupid, so technical difficulties. But take 2 in 3, 2, 1, go. It's too quiet. Oh, okay, there we go. Oh my god. God, I forgot how the details. Yeah, remember, you know, it's for everybody. Okay, good, good, good. Oh, and there he is. Oh, I used to have a crush on you. Okay, yeah, you know, we all cry right now, but you know, after this, we all gonna go beat the shit out of someone. that, like, see, my weakness, the push. Yeah, there's no I in team. You can't always do it by yourself. Don't be a dick. But you can't change time. Yes, for him, yes, it is. I mean, 'cause you got skills. Duh. Yeah, you know, call me by my first name. The guy who fucking smiles with his eyes scares the absolute shit out of me. But I like him though. You ain't no 16. mean, he just said. And I mean, but he's just being honest. Either you stay and you participate or you go. That's up to you. I mean, you can say that about like any type of sports team. It usually, even though it's like, yes, oh my God, team, it's really just about yourself at the end of the fucking day. But you can, and you will. But you say, fuck it. Take that shot. Oh, I remember this part. Oh. You give me Coney vibes. Heck, I even said that the first time when I watched this episode. Kiss them dreams fucking goodbye. Oh, but it is in a way. It's like a killing game, kind of. Oh, don't speak like that. No, don't do that. And I can't even imagine getting hit by a soccer ball. I have gotten hit by volleyballs and basketballs. Those are the worst pains in the world. I agree with Kira. It's an easy kill, which is fucked up, but you know, so. Now, the funny thing was, okay, and I'm kind of remembering how I thought after I watched this first episode. Initially, going into this, especially having, you know, our, what I like to call a spokesperson speaking and such, I don't know why, okay, as I said, it is like a death game. It is, but no one dies. Initially, when I came into this, I was thinking this was a death game, that slowly but surely, every single week, ba-dam, you know, like anything, you know, Danganronpa, any other death game that I can currently think of, fucking, what's his face on Netflix, and pff, Alice in Borderland, and a whole bunch of different things. Now, when I got, after, when I finished this first episode, I was just like, okay, it's not like that, but it kinda is. I'm not mad at it. It's good. It's different. I mean, you know, I'm not a big, I know nothing about soccer. Absolutely nothing about soccer. But you know what? I am okay with that. I am willing to learn and such. That's like, you know how I know nothing about football and it is not really my thing inish, but if I was watching a football game with like my dad or future boyfriend, whatever the thing that's gonna happen, and let's say he wasn't doing it, then yeah, I would literally ask him ins and outs of this. Now, if we were watching a soccer game, I think that'd be ins and outs because then I would probably know a little bit. He's so cute, though. He gives me like hella Haru vibes. I'm free. Where literally all he cares about is nothing but soccer, but it's so cute though. Look at him. I mean, hey, you gotta have good grades to get that good shit at the end of the day. No good grades, no good shit. But like, oh, he's just a precious baby boy. I mean, like, oh my God. But like, they're okay. So seeing anything, because I didn't get to see that was brand new for me. Because of course, you know, I was watching the show on Crunchyroll. The detail, the freaking level of detail, like when they zoom in onto their eyes and their faces and oh, I don't know why, but I was like, God dang, give this studio award, give them everything. I was like, Jesus, this is like, it's cool, but it's creepy in a way. Like, bruh, I feel like if I had that blown up in my house, future, you know, I feel bad for the one person who's gonna be walking down in my bathroom in the middle of the night and be like, oh my God, what is that? I'd be like, yes, look at this. It's pretty, isn't it? In a creepy way. But you know, hey, I like it. But the rest of the boys, like, another one that I was like hugely into was the guy who literally looks like Ichigo. And for weeks, I also got to see that on my Twitter and my TikTok and everywhere I went. I was like, yes, it's the other guy who looks like Ichigo, but he's not really Ichigo. I was like, but you know, he still gives me those vibes. Like, even rewatching this, like having him just for that in that little moment. Once again, gives you vibes of Ichigo, and he's really sweet and such. But it makes me wonder, like, what is his deal? And the same thing with everyone else. But it does make me wonder. And I didn't say this when I initially watched this for the first time with this first episode. Okay, my biggest thing was, even though they couldn't play for Japan, there's no freaking problem that they could go play for somebody else. Like I said, football in a nutshell. American football in a nutshell, because everybody gets traded to somebody else at the end of the day. So even if Japan, like, they lost their fucking dreams right here and now in whatever episode they're in, they say, my soccer dreams of playing in the World Cup for Japan, mwah, kiss that shit goodbye. There is no reason why he could not go play for anybody else. But I get it. Yes, majority of them want to play for Japan. So. What's gonna damned if you do, damned if you don't, like, bruh. It's up to you at the end of the day. But seriously, rewatching this first episode was just, it gave me those feels of how I had when I was just like very curious about this and thinking, like, oh, it's gonna be this. And then, you know, it's a different thing, but I ain't mad at it still. It still holds up, even though it's only been a couple of months. But yes, go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for episode two. All right, episode two and three, two, one, but like, it looks like a cinnamon roll can kill you. Yeah, but wouldn't you want to have that honorary, like, seen that trophy in your office? Is this man? Winning. I mean, damn. It's not bullshit, babe. It's reality. Right. Then it has everything to do with tag. Yeah, and did you really think you were gonna have enough time? Bye. You can keep calling bullshit and bullshit and bullshit. It's time for you to go. The true colors. Because your career didn't die, your dream. didn't go bye-bye, unlike someone else. He's so adorable. Yeah, he's crazy too, yes. Bruh. Just a feeling, you know. I'm still confused on that, but you know, hey. But he also gives me the "There's no I in team, all about me." something he can't explain, you know. Like a different personality esque. Yes, he is, but everything that he says is bound to make sense later. Well, if you want better food, you gotta do better. And since you guys are down at Z, you get the lowest. Oh, don't get mad. You don't have to be a dick about it, but I get you. I mean, do you think he cares? I mean, I mean, hey, whatever floats your boat. If we gotta ruin 299 people's lives, we do that. It's the best of the motherfucking best. Mean. Oh, no, no, no. He gets to pick it for you. I mean, but it's still a smart idea. And they doing it well, you say. So, okay, so now that I am officially, once again, caught up now, because the last episode I watched was this. I mean, once again, this is such a good damn series. Like, hella interesting. Very different from most sports animes that I've watched. Like, depending on my thing, I'm one of two things. It's either, like, you know, okay, of course, the cute girls cliche, where it's like, oh my god, cute girls are gonna do this, or when it is hot guys, or just, sometimes it could just be the sport. Even if I don't know jack-ish about the sport, sometimes the sport can interest me. The hot guys are usually, like, the second or third or fourth thing about it, yes. But, I mean, anything could happen in this match for, you know, Isagi and everyone else, but who really knows? Because, well, y'all know. I know nothing, because I have not seen episode 3 and 4. Did y'all literally... There ain't no you are here. I mean, okay. Bachina, he's very sweet. He kind of gives me, and I cannot believe him. Well, it's no surprise that I would compare him to this Danganronpa character, because even when I look at him, I get those vibes. So... Okay. It's kind of very obvious what it is. I really do not remember how to say his fucking name. Hold on. I gotta look it up real quick. Oh, never mind. Never mind. Kameda. Mm-hmm. Took me a moment just to, like, think about it. Really. It's just kind of like, you know, hey, we're really, like, sweet. They look sweet and innocent, but when you really, truly get to know them, and you see how, not crazy, let's say twisted, they are in the way that they think and how they tick, and that one little switch just goes off, and you see how they truly are as a person, bruh. Then that's when you'd be thinking, do I really want to be friends with this person over here? Sometimes it's a yeah, sometimes that's a no. Like I said, he's a cinnamon roll, but he could kill you. Like, straight up. You don't want to go in a dark alley with him. Like, bro, like, no. I'm good. I'm great. Nah. But I am excited to see how the rest of this is going to go. Say... For an example, like him, like he gives me, like, of course, that I've seen in, like, typical animes or just like TV shows, whatever, in a nutshell, the asshole type character who holds himself above everyone else. Like, Kira kind of gave me that vibes as well, especially once you kind of see his true colors by the beginning of episode 2 and such, where I was like, oh my god, like, you're so cute in episode 1. Like, I kind of have the hots for you. And then episode 2, it's like, wow, you really look at this dude, because he just lost, you know, sore loser type-esque. But it is what it is at the end of the day. But yeah, like, Sai does definitely give me, like, the asshole, like, it's all about me, not you type vibe and such. And I feel like somebody, you know, so he needs to be knocked off of his high horse. I get it. He does not really want to play for Japan, because he looks below them. He thinks that they are nothing. So he's like, that's why he was like, I'd rather go play with college kids, because college kids know their shit. They know what to do. Like, for them, it's no game. This is their life. But for teenagers going into it, it's slowly but surely getting up to almost the college level of, I can turn this into a career. This can be my life and such. Especially when you're at that age of going into middle school, high school, eventually into college, where it's like, yes, I can get a fucking career out of this shit. I can make thousands off of this shit. Like, bro, yes, 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 yes. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episodes 1 and 2 of Blue Lock. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad, and of course, I will see you guys officially all next Friday for episodes 3 and 4. Bye, guys!